The European Union chief is pointing to a recent incident to show that sexism is still a problem, even at the highest reaches of power. Ursula von der Leyen is the first female head of the European Commission. She was literally left standing, take a look at this video, left standing during a visit to Turkey early this month, while Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan and European Council President Charles Michel sat in gilded chairs. Von der Leyen eventually was offered a seat on a nearby sofa. Speaking to the European Parliament, she said that she felt hurt and alone.
I cannot find any justification for what I was treated in the European treaties. So I have to conclude that it happened because I am a woman. Would this have happened if I had worn a suit and a tie? In the pictures of previous meetings, I did not see any shortage of chairs. But then again, I did not see any women in these pictures neither.
Would it have happened if I had worn a suit and tie? Well, Turkey has responded. They say that they reject any accusation that von der Leyen was treated unfairly because of her gender. Joining us live now to dig deeper into this are Christiane Amanpour. So when you watch that video, Christiane, it is infuriating for anyone who has experienced discrimination or even for those who haven't. But it's important to remember, because context is really key when you look at this video, because this all comes at a time when Erdogan has pulled Turkey out of a key convention that aims to protect women's rights. Walk us through it.
Well, look, that's right. I mean, he did that before this breach of protocol, if you like, with Ursula von der Leyen. Look, she is called out today everyday sexism. That happens all the time. And often, you know, when women are the only women in the room, as she said, she is the first female head of, you know, of the European Commission. And she said she expected to be treated as the president of the European Commission. Now, what should have happened is that all three of them should have been sitting there in their gilded chairs. But it didn't happen. There are only two chairs. Obviously, Turkey is on the defensive now. It is pushing back, saying that it respects the rights of women. But you're absolutely right. Late March, President Erdogan, his popularity flagging, his need to appeal to more conservative, more sort of Islamist-leaning voters at home, he finally did what he had floated that he would do, and that is pull Turkey out of what's known as the Istanbul Convention. It is actually an international treaty that protects the rights of women and protects women from domestic and other violence. So this is part of the context, including the fact that Turkey under Erdogan has kind of succeeded in shifting the debate, the engagement with women from equality towards women to more traditional women's place in the home, in the family, etc. And this has created a backlash amongst Turkey's professional women, amongst the women in Turkey who are used to growing up in a secular political environment and who are used by and large to having their rights protected. But there's been an upsurge, and we've covered it on our program, in domestic violence and violence against women in Turkey itself.
Yeah, so women's rights in Turkey clearly under threat. Erdogan, as I mentioned, has said that, you know, this has nothing to do with sexism at all. But when you look at the video, if it wasn't to do with sexism, then what was it to do with?
Well, as Ursula von der Leyen herself said, the only conclusion that she could come to was because she was a woman. And, you know, Erdogan has said again that he wants Turkey to join the EU. You know, this has been a long, long struggle. They have not met the criteria, according to European leaders, for entrance into the EU. The absolute respect of women is obviously one of them. He has been making more friendly noises to the West since President Biden was elected. There was a huge amount of tension between Erdogan and the West under President Trump. But that seemed to be, you know, going off the boil. And, you know, he's kind of, you know, in this regard, kind of shown some of the true colors, which certainly don't match what the EU want to see from Turkey. In fact, the Council of Europe loudly decried pulling out of the Istanbul Convention and said that it just shows where Turkey's true colors are. But as I say, there has been a backlash in Turkey itself. The women there are incredibly strong, certainly, you know, the groups of professional women and others who want to see their country respect their rights as equal citizens.
And I think that what I admire most about the situation involving von der Leyen is that, as difficult And as awkward as it might be sometimes to speak up, she said something. Christiane Amanpour, live for us there. Thank you so much.